Have you ever tried learning a brand new language for fun? It's difficult, especially as an adult, but not only will you learn a new culture and be able to converse with a completely new group of people, but amazingly, you can also enhance your brain. Most of us go around communicating with our friends and family on a daily basis without realizing how amazing and highly complex human languages are. Language imparts not just simple meanings or actions, but complex emotions, phenomena, and other abstract concepts in highly structured and organized ways. Language goes far beyond just simply making sounds, as babies learn sign language in just the same way as any spoken language. And it can also encompass body language, intonation, facial expressions, among others, and it also depends how the receiver chooses to perceive and interpret it all. Most recent theories state that language processing is supported mainly by the brain. While the right hemisphere is largely responsible in interpreting visual information and spatial processing, the left hemisphere of the brain is the one responsible for language and speech. Specifically, Wernicke's area and Broca's area is where much of the language function lies. Wernicke's area, identified by Carl Wernicke in 1874, deals with the comprehension of language and the ability to communicate ideas, feelings, and concepts, whether vocal, written, or signed. People with Wernicke's aphasia speak in grammatically correct sentences, but they often make no sense, and their understanding of language is also impaired. Broca's area, on the other hand, is responsible for the production of speech. In spoken language, the neurons from Broca's area send signals to the larynx, tongue, and mouth motor areas, which then transmit to their corresponding muscles to result in the creation of sounds. Those with Broca's aphasia have difficulty physically producing the words, but their ability to understand sentences is relatively unimpaired. Not only is the brain capable of language processing, it is also capable of language learning and the accumulation of more than one language, known as bilingualism and multilingualism. Recent studies in this area have found that language learning actually has the powerful ability to alter your brain in many beneficial ways. According to Judith F. Kroll, a Penn State cognitive scientist, studies reveal how bilingualism changes networking in the brain that enables skilled cognition, supports fluent language performance, and facilitates learning. Researchers have shown that the brain's architecture of polyglots are actually different from the architecture of monolinguals. In a study examining the neural activity of English speakers who learned Chinese for 6 weeks, it was found that language learning increased brain connectivity and made the brain more integrated, thus increasing the efficiency of information processing. David Marsh, a specialized planner at Uvascular University, says that their research on multilingualism has shown that it puts people at an advantage when processing complex thoughts, which includes higher thinking and creativity, mental flexibility, interpersonal and communication skills, and may even delay age-related mental illnesses in the future. The most highlighted point in their research report is multilingualism's effect on memory function. An enhanced memory can have a huge impact on cognitive function, which is why multilingual individuals display superior performance in handling and solving complex problems. You might assume that the improved brain functions arise after individuals have gained command of multiple new languages. However, research states that changes in the brain's electrical activity may start as soon as you begin learning your second language. It is commonly believed that children are better able at learning a second language compared to adults. This might not necessarily be the case, because children and adults learn new languages in very different ways. By understanding, analyzing, and applying the knowledge through different learning processes, everyone, regardless of their age, is able to acquire a second language. For younger children, learning a new language comes as second nature. It is more intuitive and does not require a lot of conscious effort. Adult brains, on the other hand, process language in a more active way, which means that they are fully conscious about their learning process. Adults also have a much larger vocabulary and they think and communicate in much more advanced ways than children, thus making it more difficult to progress quickly, and thus they should also be taught in different ways. In teaching adults, the understanding of the language is much more important than the perfection of pronunciation, and the integration of new concepts with existing cognitive structures will help them succeed. Authors Richard M. Roberts and Roger J. Cruz state in their book that cognitive science does not support a language learning approach that focuses on memorization, drills, and other forms of mindless and mechanical learning. For adults, concepts that are learned at a deeper level or that seem to make a personal connection, regardless of pronunciation, are much more effective and better remembered compared to how children learn a language, which is by memorizing and repeating based on words or sound alone. Whether monolingual, bilingual, or multilingual, it is clear that language is a powerful tool that gives rise to much of the world around us, as our human lives would not be complete without it. But knowing more languages actually enhances your mind in even more ways than you originally thought. What languages have you always wanted to learn? Now might be a great time to start. Let us know in the comments below.